Hello everybody, today we're going to be dusting for fingerprints. You're going to need a few materials for this activity. You'll need these sheets of paper that show different kinds of fingerprints, a black piece of construction paper, you'll need a paintbrush or a makeup brush of some sort, clear tape, and then you're going to need a fine powder. So if we were professional forensic scientists, they have a very specific kind of powder they use for dusting fingerprints. But since we're at home, you can use powders you can find in your kitchen for this activity instead. So any fine powder you have will work. So baking powder or baking soda work well for this activity. You could use cornstarch. And you can also use flour if you want. I find that the baking soda and powder and cornstarch are a little nicer because they're a little finer than the flour, but you can use whatever is most convenient to you. You can also use baby powder for this activity. Our first step is going to be to take a fingerprint sample. So what we're going to do is we're going to dust our finger with some powder, and then we're going to take a piece of tape and stick it to that finger and pull it off, and the powder should pull off in and show the shape of your fingerprint. So before I start dusting my finger, I am going to pre-rip a small piece of tape about the size of my fingertip, so it's ready to go for when I take my sample. So I'm just going to stick this to the edge of my desk. So now I can dust my finger. So you can do whatever finger you want. I think I'm gonna choose my thumb. So I have a little dish of baking powder here. So I'm just gonna dip my thumb into this dish. You could also use your paintbrush to kind of paint or dust the powder on. Now, one thing that's really important about this step is that you don't put too much powder on, because if there's too much powder, when you put the tape on and pull it off, it'll just be blurry and you won't be able to tell what your print is. So as you can see, I have baking soda on my thumb, but you can hardly see it at all. And that's the right amount, especially if you're using flour. You wanna make sure that you don't put too much on. So now that there's some baking soda on my finger, I'm gonna take this piece of tape and carefully set it over the powdered finger and press it down everywhere where there's powder. And then I'm going to carefully pull it off. Once you've pulled your tape off, you should have a record of your fingerprint. It's a little hard to see on camera because my camera has trouble focusing on the tape, but you can see the pattern of my fingerprint on the tape. Once you've pulled the tape off your fingertip, you're gonna take it and carefully set it on your black piece of paper. And you're gonna wanna be really careful not to push the tape down or try to scrape it onto the paper, because that will mess up the fingerprint. It can be hard to get a clear print sometimes, so if you have to try a few different times before you get a fingerprint that you're happy with, that's totally fine. I know you guys can do it. Once you've taken your fingerprint sample and stuck it to your black paper, then you can take these fingerprint type charts that you have, and you can use these to identify your fingerprint. So mine is pretty impossible to see on camera, but if you look closely, my thumbprint is a right slope loop. You can also try taking samples of different fingers. I know for me, a lot of my fingers have different kinds of fingerprints, so that could be something interesting to compare. You could also take samples from friends or family and see how your fingertips compare to each other and what's similar and what's different.